Team Dark. Team Serral. GSL versus the world. Team match.
원래는 저가 버프를 받아야 되거든요. 너무 못해가지고 저가 세 보여요. 그래서 이게 여론이 저그가 좋다고 되는데 제 경기 보면은 딱 나오거든요. 저그가 좋은지 안 좋은지. 감염충 쓰고 우승한 애들은 그거 다시 패스해야죠. 깨끗한 사람이에요 저는. 클린한 사람이죠.
Everyone says ultra racism, but I think that's how it works. I think the balance right now isn't too bad. It's just that there's some design problems in the game, like Zerg late game is a bit too strong, and then I think CVP is a bit, it's a bit on gambly side, and I think it's pretty Protoss favored honestly early and mid game, but obviously late game it's Zerg favored right now, but we are getting the Infested Terran nerf, so I'm not sure how much it has gonna affect, and maybe that turns it even. Infester. Very bad soon. Soon very bad. But now very good, now very good. Yeah, but they're getting nerfed.
Seoul, Korea. Freak Out Studio. GSL versus the world. I want
back. So hold on guys, is that tiny change they're making to the Infester going to make it bad?
It's going to respect Ama. I think that's a nice change, but
I don't think it's the nerf that's gonna hurt. It's gonna, are they fixing the bug where it ignores armor? And if they fix that, I think that's only quite the nerf, right?
Yeah, which is what's going through. Yeah. It is going to respect armor.
Yeah. Okay. Well, I think the Fungals are still gonna hold the Viking still, but I don't.
That
know.
Is true. They will still do that.
What do I know? Damn, I'm just a commentator.
You're a Protoss player. What are you talking about?
Yeah,
TDZ for?
Yeah. Stay in your lane, Artosis. Oh, do you guys think that Serral just takes this?
Yeah.
I mean,
yes.
I think this is.
No, yeah, of course.
I don't want to, you know.
So let's talk about that asteroid.
I want to be very candid. Yeah, I mean, I just feel like this is should be pretty straightforward. I mean, it's either going to be an insane upset, and we'll know which team has won, or Serral just wins because he's Serral and he's the best player in the world.
Yeah, even though last time Serral did win 3-0 against Sue, historically, Sue kind of had Serral's number. Not only the IM Katowice, but if you think back of Nation Wars last year in Paris as well, Sue actually defeated Serral twice. So Serral did seem to struggle with Sue in the past, but I think right now, I don't want to say Sue has like fallen off, but I think he's just like in a little dip, you know, like a little summer dip. I don't know. Maybe he's been enjoying the weather a little too much.
Playing a lot of golf.
Yeah, exactly. You don't know, Sue is it.
I mean, Sue as well.
Serral might get stronger when he plays golf. I don't know. But I think that Serral's just in better shape right now than Sue is.
Yeah, I think that that's probably fair. But Sue is kind of one of those funny players where he goes down and then you start thinking, he's going to lose. And then he's like, okay, GSL Finals.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, I mean, the fact that he got to that many finals is really something because you to do it that many times means you can basically beat anybody. You just somehow can't win when it's the most important moment. But I mean, I don't think this is really a high-pressure situation.
No.
For Sue, I think he's, which no. might benefit him. You know, I think Sue's kind of one of these players that operates best when it's not as important. Like you know, when we have these big finals matches, we've been shocked at how many times he's actually lost. But look, I mean, he's the underdog here. It's against Serral. If he wins, awesome. If he loses, okay, it wasn't his fault. You know, he got thrown to the lions here.
Well, if he does do well, then that's going to be fantastic for Team Dark because they're about to get a nice payday because they are on match point. Just take a step back from
eight grand.
That's right. So basically about a grand per player.
Yeah.
Not a bad day's work.
Yeah. No, not at all.
Yeah. Okay.
We don't have much else to say about this one.
Well, how about this? No. I think Sue's going to win. What do you guys think about that?
Wow. Well, we're going to disagree again with you, Artelsis. We can disagree with Dan. You know, that's a really funny segment. We can talk about Todd, but we can also just disagree with Dan. And there's a
lot
of things.
Thing we can do. Yeah.
Like, we talk about the asteroid that's absolutely going to destroy the
entire
planet.
Let's talk about your bug that you're going to go into when the asteroid hits the Earth and the entire planet's destroyed as it goes into the sun.
How deep is this bunker? What's it made of? Yeah.
What is it made of?
Yeah.
Neo steel?
Titanium alloy.
Vibranium? Is it Captain America's shield?
Bunker, it's made out of unobtainium.
What kind of a bunker is
it? Listen,
then?
When you guys are pounding on my door, I'm going to sit there with my intercom system that still works because the meteor hasn't hit yet. And I'm going to be like, Wait a minute, didn't you guys make fun of me and like think
No Fedora support here.
Wow. Sorry, all the white knights out there in Twitch chat right now.
M'lady?
M'lady.
M'lady?
Neeb needs a fedora.
Did he drawn? Yeah. I wonder if he drew something.
I think he drew something. Oh, but
he's definitely drawn something.
Yeah, he just doesn't want to show up. He's a little bit shy, you know. Doesn't want to.
Maybe he's not that good.
He doesn't want to be. He doesn't want to get out there on camera, you know.
There's something about Artosis being a Terran player and thinking that he needs to wall himself in from an asteroid. There's just something to this.
Yeah.
You guys just sit on the surface and watch it come, and when the flame wall comes and devours you, I'll be underground watching old GSL VODs, reliving the glory days. Okay, with all my canned goods.
Are you trying to queue up on Battle.net, hoping there's someone else in a bunker somewhere?
And that's when you're going to see you had two missed calls all along. And they were from Nesty.
That's right.
In his other bunker, because he too had a bunker.
And then you and Nesty have to play StarCraft against each other. That's right. You're the only people on Battle.net.
We'll be the best. We'll have the best CVCs nobody ever saw. It'll be amazing.
Too.
Yeah.
That's funny. I think this is going to be really cool, though. There's obviously a little bit of pressure here on the shoulders of Serral, but it seems that Serral just never really buckles under pressure. Yeah, like, he loses games sometimes, but that's just because his opponents play very well. I never really feel it's like, oh, wow, Serral really felt the pressure, you know, like he couldn't bring it. It's like, no, he's actually, like, he pretty much always performs at least B+, and most of the times it's like A- or A+. So I think he's going to be more than fine. And obviously, I think it would be cool for all of us to at least see him win here. And then Big Gabe, I mean, maybe Big Gabe could close it out
But he was looking really good in the tournament. He's one of those players with fantasy where it was like, ah, oh, this is criminal that they finish up 1-3. You know?
Yeah, he got the map that Big Gabe won against Trap was actually really convincing. Like, it was a really sick game.
Yeah.
It's on Thunderbird, right?
I believe so. And, you know, that that King's Cove game was super cool.
Maybe it was Kairos, actually. Yeah, Kairos.
Yeah, on Thunderbird, he tried to win with the Raven. He tried to disable the
Sentry.
He was very close, though, so you were spot on that regard.
Okay, we're about to start this match. This is Sue versus Serral.
Who's Serral, casting tape?
So Serral needs to...
Am I casting
this
this
time?
Is it you?
You guys can tag me
solo
at any time.
Casting this one.
I knew it. It's time. Guys, I'm solo casting this one in my two different voices. Let's go.
Team match. Match 7.
What's up, guys? Nick Tasteless Plot here with my really convincing Australian accent in the bottom right in the red, representing Team Dark.
Chivo, Sue.
And on the left top side of this beautiful map, I am the best caster by
the voice of GSL.
It is.
Ents Esports, Serral.
Of course, the reigning champion of GSL vs. the world. The reigning champion of the WCS Global Finals. And pretty much almost every single tournament that he's attended over the last year and a half. Oh my goodness.
Start them young. They'll grow up to be great players one day.
That's so cute. So what, after watching all of these games, what race do you think they would
pick? I think they go home to their players.
Yeah.
Everyone complains about how strong their units are. Serral's brother, Protosser, again on camera. What's up, mate? Saw him last year at GSL vs. the World as well, supporting his brother for that big win.
Yeah, and they had a very cool video about him as well back
then. Yeah, I remember that. Or so the Signature Series.
Yeah, they released it at the end of the year, but it was still really cool. I'm Protosser. Also a very good player.
You can't do that when I'm drinking. I just love the Finnish accent.
Me too, I love all of it. All right.
So interesting build.
You know, Serral, actually what I love about this whole day that we've seen so far is in the beginning of the day, he's like, I really want to play Raynor, but I can't, you know, because Raynor was already scheduled to play Fantasy first. But it really does feel that Serral, even though he's such a humble, sweet guy and he's never cocky, and if there's one thing, like I was thinking about this yesterday, don't ask me why I was thinking about it, is that I've never heard Serral say anything about prize money. And I actually really kind of like that. Like, can you remember a single moment where he's like, oh, it's so great to win all this money, or I want to win that tournament because of money? No, it's like he mentions trophies. Like, he likes trophies and stuff. But I really feel like his motivation and stuff, and when it comes to his character, it's just all in the right place. But it does feel that he takes losses pretty personal, right? So Raynor defeating him twice, he's like, I really, really want to play Raynor all the time right now.
Never mentions prize money, always talks about trophies and trophies that are missing from his cabinet. I mean, I personally, I won all that prize money. Every time I go live, my Twitch title would say Maynard, the 500K boy.
Oh, absolutely.
We'll Lair very quickly here from Sue.
No, and I think it's like normal as well in some interviews, be like, yeah, maybe like there's more pressure or I really want to win this tournament because the prize was so big. This Link Scout could be massive. I mean, Sue is playing a risky game here, guys. He's most likely going to go for a very crazy build.
Like a roach timing or...
Yeah, there's so many things on Kairos that you can do, right? You can do like the Lambo build, as I like to call it, like the 34 drone plus one roach attack. But this could also still be like a Nidus build. He could also just fake the Roach one and actually go for Spire.
What I really like with this build is what Sue's doing here is you can actually, you know, with the Lair, get that Overlord creep highway happening.
Yeah.
And and rally Lambo very, very quickly. The Lambo build, yeah. That's actually my favorite usage. I've seen it a lot in WCS as well.
Yep. And that's actually a build that some people use very effectively against Serro as well in the past. Lambo being one of them, I think. There was another Zerg that actually, I think, Serro actually tried that build against Raynor in the most recent WCS Global Finals, and it didn't work at all. Single Spinecrawler, it was going to be enough. We do see that plus one missile attacks, but it seems like Sue just wants to sort of macro up by now, for now, because he's got a lot of drones out already. It's 37, yeah. And he's getting 5 more.
It's really quick roach speed, I guess. Yeah. I mean, getting roach speed this early, usually you want to capitalize on it and try and do something with it, because you can get across the map and also retreat out of the battle really quickly. Mm-hmm. He's going towards a third.
Yeah, there should be a couple of links, right? No links anymore? No?
Doesn't look like it. Checking that minimap. Just looks like Overlords.
Actually, a bit surprising, because normally you would expect if you have Zergling speed too. You don't want to make too many Zerglings, obviously, but just having like 4 or 6 links to be annoying at that moment and potentially pick off a drone or at least delay that expand for, even if it's just 10 or 15 seconds, that kind of stuff can come in very handy. But it seems like Serral just wanted to drone up a little bit more. Whoa. So he's got a tiny worker advantage, but it's really important that he starts getting nothing but drones from this point. Otherwise, Sue's going to have a real opportunity to potentially even get the victory here for Team Dark.
Nothing but roaches, yeah. And he's making a lot of them right now, tucking them into that natural.
Yeah.
Both players are in the dark a little bit, but it looks like Sue's got some links to the north side here. Does have an Overseer. But, yeah, I mean, you're absolutely right, Roddy.
Uh-oh.
Droning right now is a bit of a death sentence for Serral.
Yep.
I mean, there are some miracle engagements. If anyone's going to win a miracle engagement from behind an army supply, it will be this kid. But this is already on paper looking quite bad.
Yeah, that's bad. He just made 4 drones. He made an Evo Chamber. Now he's making Overlords. None of these things. I mean, obviously, the Overlords he's going to need. But he needs units. Serral actually needs nothing but units. I think he saw a couple of roaches moving out now. And he does have quite a few roaches defensively, actually. I mean, on paper, actually, the build of Sue just doesn't look that great.
Yeah, he's like, I'm going to make a ton of roaches. Then I'm going to make 12 drones.
Yeah.
It's just a little bit interesting.
I'm a bit confused about what Sue is doing here, but let's see if he can find a tiny window to maybe get ahead. But, I mean, maybe in the end, Serral building those drones was the correct call, because Sue is not really committing. I'm confused. It's been a weird game. It's almost like they're both feinting each other and not exactly sure where they are right now in the fight.
Well, the third is scouted here for both players. Sue can see the edge of the creep. Serral can see the mining. Overseer rolling into that natural, contaminating the Evo chamber here. That's not the one with +2 attack, though, which is, of course, the most important upgrade when you're going for Roach versus Roach. But it does certainly help. And with that double Evo, that's potentially an upgrade lead here for Serral as that contaminate wears off.
Like, I think Sue absolutely has the skills to defeat Serral, as he's shown us quite a few times in the past. But I do feel like it often comes down to getting ahead early on or getting ahead in the mid game, right? By a crazy attack, a good engagement. I think the longer the games go in general, and I mean, this goes for Serral against any Zerg player in the world, Serral's the best when it comes to late game Zerg. He's the best when it comes to the Infestors and the Vipers and that kind of stuff. So I feel like the longer it goes, the less likely it will be that Sue is going to get a victory here. Now, obviously, there's nothing wrong with maxing out on roaches, and Sue can play that game very well. He's obviously great with Ravages and that kind of stuff. But I do feel he kind of needs to push the issue at that point before like we really start thinking about Lurkers and stuff.
Sue keeps contaminating this Evo Chamber, probably under the impression that's the attack upgrade. Because with +2, you know, the roaches really do hit a power spike there, and I think that's probably the plan here for Sue. He's making a lot of roaches right now, some more overlords as well. So, but Serral's doing the same thing, and he's going punch for punch with these upgrades and defender's advantage if Sue goes across the map.
Yep.
He sees with his overseer how many units Serral has.
Now, Sue's going to need a miraculous engagement, right? That's kind of what this all boils down to. Numbers-wise, he's really not going to be very far ahead. Whoa!
Headshot.
That's sick! I can't believe that he got that. I mean, well done. That must feel good as well. I see supply blocks Serral too. 8 overlords on the way now. I mean, he's going to try that one more time. So this is it. I mean, Sue needs to get a little bit lucky with positioning, and he needs to kind of fake Cerro out and somehow outmaneuver him and get a very good fight, either on the top or the bottom, it doesn't really matter. But this is really where Su wants to strike. Otherwise, Cerro's actually going to be ahead in upgrades. And we all know, once again, the longer it goes, the better things get for Cerro.
And Cyril, with his overseers and just overlord spread here, keeping on tabs of Sue's army. If Sue gets into a nice choke point between the natural and the third, that's really a lights out for Cyril. But he gets on top of that ramp and the nice little concave and that high ground. Sue is pulling his way up. He's eating some biles in these units, but it's himself a nice wall of roaches. All of Cyril's units are fighting right now, bar one or two roaches. Sue's army actually taking a bit of a hit, but it is still larger.
Yeah, still has all of his ravages. I think that's the most important thing. But overall, that seemed like a very even fight. The south side, I think it went quite even as well. But Cerro, maybe with some reinforcements in the end, got the job done. Here we go. This is kind of what we were talking about. Su is indeed really committing. He wants to make more happen. And hey, with a higher ravage count, anything is possible. One good wave of corrosive piles, and it could very well be victory for Su and victory for Team Dark.
And as far as roaches go, Cyril does have one upgrade lead. He's got plus one carapace. We could make a deal here, especially considering the armies are so close in size. But you're absolutely right. The biles don't really care. If he gets some nice biles, it could be a run-through here for Su. It was very close to maxed out as he goes towards his fourth hatchery.
Yep. Maybe he can get a cancel on the fourth base. It's important, obviously, for
Cyril's intercepting.
Yeah, then he gets down there. Get a little choke on all of those overlords. Great scouting by Cerro. And obviously, I mean, that's what you're supposed to do. There isn't really that much for Su that shoots up here. You want to keep track of the army movement. Now, Su is going to try one more time to get up this ramp. He's got a lot of ravages, but Cerro is just collapsing on this army. Very confident that he can take the fight. And I think he's right, Maynard.
Me too, Roddy. He just springboards off that creep with so many roaches. Su's army supply advantage vanishing before his eyes here. A Cerro with that upgrade advantage just crushes it. He just seems to know within milliseconds what every time he's going to win an engagement.
Yep, he looks at an army, he's like, yep, I eye it, I see it, I like it, I can take that fight, and I'm going for it. Gets right on top of all of it. Now, Su's still in this game. Really no man overboard, right? He's only down a little bit in supply. He's down an upgrade, and that kind of stinks. But I think above all, like, he invested in a lot of ravages, and he lost all of his ravages. But if you look on the side of Cerro, Cerro actually maintained 9 of those ravages from before.
Which is a big deal. That means that his opponent, if he goes across the map, which he's doing right now, has to respect the corrosive biles every time that they're dodging the biles. They're taking shots on the roaches, second here, second there. And Cerro is going towards Spire, something he's been showing a lot of in this tournament. So this means that Cyril's ground army, while it is bigger, isn't going to grow too much larger here, because he wants to start potentially going up into some air units. So it's a bit of a precarious moment here for Cyril. If Su goes really ham on the roach production, you can definitely punish, but with this army of Cyril, it just doesn't seem doable.
I mean, Cyril's maxed out anyway, though, right?
Yeah.
Like, so I think what he's most likely going to do is like going to bank up some resources, and if their fights happen where it's like, okay, we both lose like 40 supply, then he can remake Mudas, but I don't think he's going to do it at a very weird moment or a dangerous moment. Now, Cyril's going to try his luck here in the natural of Su. Don't forget, he still has that upgrade advantage. He's got way more ravages, so these fights eventually are supposed to go very good for the Finnish Zerg.